Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, Lesson Number 23. The topic is Internal Land Forming Processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudhoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to look at the wound distribution of the earthquake and then effect of the earthquake. Let us look at how the earthquake is being distributed in the whole world. Now, when we talk about the earthquake distribution, you are going to get it is mainly found in areas where we have the faulting has taken place and in areas where we have the volcanic activities. So that is the reason as to why. When you take the mid-Atlantic belt and the mid-Indian Ocean ridge, this is the places where we have the plate movement. They moved away from one another. So there is the line of weakness that was created there. Then number two, we have in the Great Rift Valley region. This is where now the faulting has also taken place. So the lines of weakness is here. They are the ones that facilitate the earthquake. Then we have the Circum-Pacific Belt. The ring of fire. The reason as to why it is referred to as the ring of fire, it is because this is the main area where we have the major and catastrophic earthquakes. Then we have the Mediterranean belt, the mid Southeast Asia region. Then we have in areas of volcanic activities, those areas that are having volcanic activities, volcanic features are associated with earthquake. You can be able to see all those areas that we have mentioned, how they are, where they are. You can see them from the image, from the map. Then we go now to the effect of the earthquake. One, it triggers the landslides. As you can be able to see, there is a landslide that has been caused when we have the earthquake. So, the landslides are triggered by the earthquake. Then number two, it triggers fire. There is an image or a photograph of an area where fire started after experiencing the earthquake. Then we have the third one, we have the tremors, weakens the structure of the earth, that's followed by the major earthquakes. So you can see the way it has become weak. We have the faultings. So as a result, if at all the shaking comes again, then it means that it will be catastrophic. It will be a major one. It will cause a lot of destruction. Then it leads to the loss of lives and destruction of property. Like the way you can be able to see, there is a house that has been destroyed by the earthquake. The earthquake has taken place. Then destruction of the building. As the destruction of the building, as it is collapsing, you can be able to see the damaging even goes to the cars. And number five, they restrict the development of towns. Those areas where we have the major catastrophes, those areas where they are prone to the earthquake, there is no building of great towns. This is because they limit people on what to do. Because when we have the catastrophic, they will leave no house standing. So as a result, people will prefer having the semi-permanent ones. Then it causes the tsunamis that causes the destruction when they get to their shores. If I tell you look at that tsunami, in case now it comes to the shores, it will destroy that barrier. So as a result, they are too dangerous. They even cause the death of people. If at all they were there swimming, fishing, they die. They can either lower or raise the sea floor. As you can be able to see how the earthquake takes place, it is resulting either sinking that is the subsidence or emergence of the coastline. So as a result now, it affects the sea level. Activity for today, explain four effects of the earthquake. If at all you want to refer, you can get the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 2, third edition. If at all you want to contact us, you can get us from either you use an SMS, you can also get us from the YouTube, you can also get us from the Facebook, or you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Iternal TV.